The clock is ticking on an unprecedented effort to recall half of the Wisconsin State Senate. Recall committees have been organized in 16 state Senate districts, targeting 8 Republicans and 8 Democrats. It's part of the fallout from the battle over collective bargaining in this state. Recall committees have 60 days to collect, on average, 15,000 signatures. We're joined now by two of the recall organizers. Christopher Rowe is with the committee to recall Alberta Darling, the Republican senator who represents Milwaukee's North Shore. And Dan Hunt is with the taxpayers to recall Robert Wirch, the Democratic senator who represents Kenosha County and Burlington. Dan Hunt, I'll begin with you. Let's talk for a moment about the motivations for this. What is fueling this desire beyond the fact that these Democratic senators went across state lines and stayed away from their jobs for a while? Is there anything else at play here?
Actually not, Mike. That is exactly the motivation that we have. We went into action actually the day after the senators went to Illinois. To us, that's something that's absolutely wrong for representative democracy. To leave your seat when the Senate is in session is wrong. It's something that should never happen.
Christopher Rowe, you did not like Alberta Darling's vote on the collective bargaining issue that strips most of the collective bargaining rights. But is there more to it than that?
There is. There actually is quite a bit. We held a town hall meeting before we actually started the signature gathering process, and all of the sentiments seemed to be very similar, as that Alberta Darling was out of touch with her constituents, not getting back to them, and people just felt that she wasn't listening. And so beyond just the one single vote, was that she wasn't representing her constituents either.
You need more than 20,000 signatures to move forward. How far along in that process are you? Will you get the signatures?
We absolutely will. I mean, we're doing very well. We have several thousand so far. Every weekend we get a lot of people showing up. The first weekend we collected signatures, we had over 600 volunteers come through the doors to sign up to go out and collect signatures. Last weekend was not as many, but it was equally as successful, and we feel this weekend is also going to be
several really thousand. Can you be any more specific than that?
We don't want to. Because we vet every signature, we put them into a database and check for validity and things like that. So I don't want to be too specific, just because we don't want people to know how. We're doing very, very well.
Okay,
let
Dan,
me just say that.
Let me ask the same question of you. You need more than 13,000 signatures. Where are you in that process?
We're also doing very, very well. The passion has run deep, and as a result, we started with a bang, and that's been continuing. The momentum has been very strong. But I can only echo what Chris has already said. I don't want to put a number on it either, and for largely the same reasons. We're doing well. Things are going well. We expect to be able to have the recall.
How do you sustain the momentum, though? Because the Democrats are now coming back to work. They're back in the state. How do you keep that going?
Well, it actually boils down to our volunteers and what they're willing to do. And we have a strong base of volunteers, like Chris as well. Our first meeting, we had well over 600 people show up. And so it's just a matter of staying in touch with them and being able to keep the issue in front of them and make sure they're out doing their job. Now, we're probably organized a little bit differently in that we just tell our volunteers, go get signatures. We've done a few other things. For instance, one of our successful strategies has been drive-through signatures. So we set up at a place, and people literally drive their cars into where we are, sign the petition, and move on. And that's been very successful.
A question for both of you. Why not just wait until 2012? Save the taxpayers a few bucks and address these issues when they come up. If this vote about Alberta Darling is, as you say, more about her general, whether or not she's in touch with the people she's representing.
Well, that's exactly why we can't wait. She ran in 2008 as more of a moderate Republican, and the constituents feel that she has moved farther and farther from that position. And she champions many of Governor Walker's policies, which are very unpopular in our district. So we feel that we can't wait until 2012 when she would be up for re-election.
Is this truly organic? I keep hearing people tell me this is an organic movement, and yet you read reports about the Democratic Party helping with these efforts, organized labor helping, groups from Utah helping, outside groups helping, even the Republican Party helping. Is it truly organic, or is there something else going on here? Dan Hunt.
Our movement is absolutely organic. I'm a neophyte when it comes to politics. I'm inexperienced. I'm an amateur. I decided to lead this effort because I felt I had the skill set to be able to do it. As far as the Utah group, which would be, you know, someone coming from our perspective, I am not working with them in any way whatsoever. So we are really, truly organic. Every signature we get will come through volunteer effort.
You feel the same? Is it an organic movement?
Absolutely. Of course, the Democratic Party and labor organizations, they have a vested interest in seeing us succeed. So they do help in certain capacities, but this is the people's movement. It's all about the people. They stand beside us. Nobody's standing in front of us.
I've got 30 seconds left. You both have full-time jobs. You're a respiratory therapist. You're a developer. How can you do both?
Well, fortunately for me, I'm my own boss, so I get up in the morning telling myself what to do.
And?
My passion for this is runs deep, and I just feel that somebody's got to do it, so I can do it.
All right. Gentlemen, we appreciate your time. Dan Hunt with the recall effort for Robert Wirch, Christopher Rowe with the recall effort for Senator Alberta Darling. Thanks to both of you for your time today. Appreciate
it. Thank you, Mike.
Next, why one of the Wisconsin 14 wants to stop others from doing what he did, preventing a vote by leaving the state. And later, saving taxpayers money by reducing the number of state lawmakers.